You can't get away!
What's up here?
If you're willing to come out now.
Musical password, let me guess, to open the secret passage. Alright, well, I don't have anything to block the door, so I guess I just need to work fast.
Give yourself up, outsider.
Alright, there's the secret passage, which is not very secret. It's actually blatantly visible, which is weird. I can't pick this up, can I?
You're trapped. There's no place you can run.
It's the minister of the church. He's been hung up and disemboweled as some sort of obscene spectacle.
Oh my god.
The pulpit is stained with blood.
Alright, I need, oh yeah, the postcard. The postcard is supposed to give me information. Alright, what is it? An old postcard pierced with four handmade holes. There are some strange handwritten instructions on the back. Okay, can I read them? Is it in my journal? Postcard, okay. You don't access the postcard by clicking on the postcard, you access it by going into your collation of general evidence. That's weird. On the back of the postcard, there's a handwritten religious verse. It must be a coded message. It reads, I ring the bells unto thy glory, O Lord, from the lowest unto the highest, and by the sacrament of baptism shall I enter into your secrets. Is that... seriously? That's how you do it? From lowest to highest? That's it? This might be the easiest secret, the easiest password ever made. I mean, that's... isn't that like the musical bell equivalent of setting your password as 1234? The postcard must also serve some other purpose. It is pierced by four handmade holes, each circled with a number of arrows. The arrows seem to signify some sort of order. Okay, lowest to highest. Doesn't sound complicated.
If you're willing to come out now, we'll not gut the gal's carcass.
Lowest to highest. So, this one. Then this one. And this one.
Give yourself up, outsider. There's no way out of there.
Did that not do it? I don't know, would it just like open up?
Trapped. There's no place you can run.
Nope, that's not right.
I should let the bell finish ringing first.
Alright. I'm pretty sure I already did it. From the lowest unto the highest. Yeah, I'm assuming they're talking about pitch and not their actual height. Yep, there we go.
Just give yourself up, outsider. The order will have mercy on your rotten souls.
That is a ridiculously stupid puzzle. It's mind-numbingly easy. I mean, you do the musical equivalent of having your password as 123. And to make it even worse, it opens a secret passage that is so blatantly obvious that it's not even a secret. I mean, you can just see it. It's right here. God damn it. This entire corner of the church is taken up by the so-called secret passage. People have been coming here, presumably, for years.
There's no way out of there.
You don't think they'd say, hey, what's that weird thing taking up the entire corner of the church? Why did it not open? Come on, finish.
Open these doors, outsider!
Okay, it didn't open again.
Just give yourself up, outsider.
Do I need to do it slowly?
On your rotten soul. You can't get away!
Did I break the game? Why is it not opening?
If you're willing to come out now.
Okay, let it finish completely.
We'll not cut the gal's carcass.
Completely finish. lowest to highest.
Give yourself up, outsider. There's no way out of there.
I think I broke the game. Yeah, let me load my game. I don't know what the hell happened. It just won't open anymore. Holy crap. Weird sensitivity.
You can't get away!
Yeah, for some reason the sensitivity of your mouse in this game seems to be tied to your FPS, so if it goes higher or lower than normal, it goes crazy.
If you're willing,
it still didn't open! What? Lowest to the highest.
I should let the bell finish ringing first.
I'm confused. It just worked. What am I doing differently? Highest to lowest?
You're trapped. There's no place you can run.
Nope. Wait, yes? What? Okay. Don't question it, just go down the hole. Maybe when he said lowest to highest, he did mean actual physically lowest, not lowest pitch. I don't know. Whatever, let's go. Is this written in blood?
There are markings everywhere. It must have been down here that Rebecca's father figured out that mysterious sign.
These kind of look like they're written in blood. Alright, this is kind of creepy. This place kind of looks demonic. I mean, you have a freaking skull candle. I would say that's a pretty good mark of a demonic place. Skull candles. That and pentagrams.
It's a registry of births, deaths, and marriages in Innsmouth.
Hmm.
They all appear to be volumes on the history of Innsmouth.
Yeah, he's obviously, he's been doing a lot of research. Lots of newspaper clippings and notes. And pictures and things circled.
All these articles relate to the deaths of Innsmouth citizens.
What was he researching? Registry of births, deaths, and marriages. 1844. Births, 7. 6 baptized, 1 died. Deaths, 5. 6. 5 buried, 1 lost at sea. Marriages, 5. Okay, the year after, 1845. 9 births, all baptized. 7 deaths, 5 buried, 2 lost at sea. Marriages, 3. Okay. Year after, 1846. 12, all baptized. Whoa! 243. Oh, 46. 235, and the disturbance and the epidemic. Yeah, that was the year of the crazy stuff. 240 buried, 3 lost at sea. 2 marriages. Next year. Probably 7, no baptized. Oh, baptism stopped? Probably 7, no baptisms. 3 reported, 2 burials, 1 coffin, upon being accidentally dropped, broke open and was found to contain rocks and logs. This was not buried. No marriages registered. So they wanted people to think someone was dead, but it was just rocks and logs. What? Why? So they weren't actually dead. Maybe they had been transformed. 48. No births, probably 10, no baptisms. 5 reported, 1 funeral, others not certain. No registered marriages. 49. None registered, thought to be 7 or 8. No baptisms, none, none, none. Alright, so after the year of the stuff that happened, the disturbances and the epidemic, people stopped bothering to register their marriages and their births and any baptisms. No baptisms, I mean.
There's a small stone disc here, hollowed out with the carving of an upside-down cross.
Well, I can guess what I need. A cross.
It's the coffin of S. Lawrence, born 1789 and died in 1826.
Perhaps one of those is the combination?
It's the coffin of S. Lawrence, born 1789 and died in 1826.
Writing it down. Okay, S. Lawrence, got it. Any other coffins have tags?
The disc is raised a little from the rock. I can't move it by hand.
Wait, what is this?
A small memorial to an old priest. A small memorial to an old priest. In the clippings, the year 1846 has been circled several times.
1846, yep, that is the year. Where all this stuff happened. What exactly did happen again? I don't remember. 1846, Innsmouth Courier. Obin Marsh, the head of Innsmouth, the wealthy and influential Marsh family, now sits in the city jail accused of devil worship and other unspeakable practices. Okay, so yeah, he was arrested, but somehow he managed to come out on top, right? Like, he's accused of devil worship, but then the church was basically destroyed, pretty much. After this, right? Like, no more baptisms, no more registering marriages.
It's the coffin of Tom Pickett, who died in 1837, aged 49.
Alright, so there's many name tags.
It's the coffin of Dee Slocum, who died in 1852, aged 27. It's the coffin of Tom Pickett, who died in 1837, aged 49. All these books are covered in dust and cobwebs. They haven't been studied for some time.
Any more wait, is that? What is that?
A small stone plaque engraved with a series of numbers.
I don't know what to make of that. Is there any particular order to them? 2, 1, 4, 8, 8, 3, 2, 5, 7, what? Okay, I can already tell this is going to take me some time to solve.
History was never my strongest subject.
You and me both, Jack Walters. Yeah, this is going to take me some time to figure out. Okay, so I'm going to cut to when I figure out what the heck to do.
The postcard fits exactly over the plaque. I can see some of the numbers.
Oh, the postcard!
It appears to be some sort of code.
Well, it's pretty obvious what to do now. I was overthinking it. I was looking at, like, plaques and looking at dates and stuff. That's all I needed to do. Alright, so... starting clockwise, it is 3... and then 1... and then 5, and then 7. Okay. Three. One. Five and seven. Boom.
Yes. Yes, that's it. I've cracked it.
I have managed to deduce what these...
I don't need the postcard anymore.
I've managed to deduce what these strange symbols mean. It took me many, many hours, and a lot of brain power, but I finally was able to do it.
The safe holds a stone cross.
Alright, what does that do? Oh! Another secret passage. A secret passage within a secret passage. And there's something stuck in my throat. Hold on. Ah, that's better. And I'm back into the sewers. Great. I love the sewers so much. I really don't like being down here. I'm amazed Jack Walters can function at all. He is so close to just being completely cracked. His brain is just broken. Did I just go in a circle? I did. They have their skeletal hands wrapped around the bars. They tried to escape, but they never got out. Oh god. There they are. Alright, what's my next destination? Is it the water tower? Oh, god. Oh, they turned around, kind of. Yeah, I'm not going that way. Let's go this way. Why is this place on fire? Are they trying to... Are they trying to burn me out or what? Why is this on fire? Alright, I think this is the way to go. Ah! Ow. They're gonna come inside of the bank. Are they really gonna go inside of a burning building, though? Doesn't seem like a wise idea. Gotta make a jump. Yep, they're coming.
Search the area.
Shit! Some of the planks look weak. I better watch my step.
Nice and easy. Is this one gonna break too? I don't know if I should go across there. Okay, even if I do make it to that side, where am I gonna go? I could go up that board and go up there. But I could also jump over here. which seems like the better option. Let's go. Whew. Okay, that was better. Now, where the hell am I going? Up here? Down? No, not down there. Yeah, it's gotta be up here. But I'm not stepping on that board. Yep, see? That's exactly why I didn't step. Oh god, they see me. They see me. Go, 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 go. Whew. Can I make it? Well, I think I have to. Let's go. Oh.
Spread out, man.
In the name of the order of Dagon, find the outsider and kill him.
Spread out.
Okay, there's the water tower. There's the water tower, making progress.
Touch the area. Search the area.
All right, I think I need to make the... Yeah, I've got to jump. Here we go.
Search the area.
Ooh.
Spread out.
All right, what's inside of here? Ooh. I have a feeling they're just going to endlessly say, search the area and spread out. Yep, that's what they're gonna do. Okay, I'm gonna leave. Wh- Ow. Am I hurt? No, I'm not. Just a little nick, I'm fine. I don't need medical attention.
Search the area.
Alright. I'm getting closer to them. God, where do I go from here? Not that way, that's for sure. Do I need to jump there? Or just fall down? No, I can't fall down, I'd break my legs. Right? Wouldn't I? Can I make that jump? We're about to find out. Oh my god, that was close. Alright, couple ways I could go. Let's go this way.
Search the area.
Oh god. I messed up. Whoops. Let's try that again. This time, jumping sooner so that I don't just fall off. Wow. See, this is how I remember my playthroughs going originally. This is the kind of stuff I had to keep doing again and again to finally get it right.
Search the area.
All the while, they repeat, search the area, and spread out about a million times.
Spread out.
I think they saw me. Anyway, let's make this jump. There we go. Oh shit, they're actually shooting at me.
Spread out.
Hello, Jack.
Mackie, have you been tailing me?
You could say that. Drop me a line next time you're planning on taking the stealthy approach. I'll watch and take notes.
Funny. I don't get it, Mackie. What's your angle on all of this?
I already told you. I work for the government. I've got friends at the top. Friends who've invested a lot of time and dough in Innsmouth. They don't want to see their investigation set back by some private op turning up the heat with some mindless caper.
If you mean the Burnham boy, they're gonna kill him, Mackie. You know it, and I know it. I can't let that happen.
You're not thinking of breaking him out. He's just a punk, Jack.
Where's the jailhouse, Mackie?
Very well. It's your funeral. The window over there to your left looks over the jail back alley.
See you around, Mackie.
You show up at the oddest times, Mackie.
It won't budge. Decorative vases and bowls.
Spread out.
All of them empty.
Oh my god, please take me away from these people that keep saying spread out and search the area. Stop. For the love of god. Okay, I think I'm through it. Jailbreak. February 8th, 1922. Early hours. Everything in this godforsaken town is out to kill me. Around every corner, some hideously tainted thug is searching. I've managed to avoid them so far, though poor Rebecca wasn't so lucky. It's starting to look hopeless. Only Mackie doesn't seem to want me dead, and maybe he has an ulterior motive. His mention of investors in this town and his knowledge of the esoteric order clearly point to some level of involvement. Still, he told me where to find Brian Burnham, and he seems to pose no immediate threat. Even so, his apparent understanding of things in Innsmouth is unnerving. Am I becoming paranoid? After what I have seen and experienced, how could I know? The strain is certainly having an effect on my nerves. I'm beginning to hear and see things that can't possibly be real. I need to ignore these distractions if I want to get out of here alive. My best chance is to find Brian and break him out of the jailhouse. To do that, I'll need a plan. I think this is the level where you first get a weapon.
It won't open.
What was that?
Nice and quiet.
Probably nothing.
Yep, nothing. Nothing at all. Nothing at all. Just a rat. Must have been the wind. Just a shadow. What?
He's over there.
How did... Okay, that was strange. No, close the door. Well, that did not go well. You know, just kill me. Just kill me. Yes, please kill me. What are you doing? Kill me. Seriously? There you go. Let's try that again, shall we? I really don't know how it got seen. The police guy just turned around, but maybe it's not him that saw me, but rather someone else that alerted the policeman to my location. I'm not sure, but I'm gonna be more careful next time.
Probably nothing.
That's what that sound was. Someone closing their shutters. Alright, I'm in the shadow and I'm sneaking.
You got anything to report?
Nope. We should be out there, Nathan. Helping with the hunt.
You have your orders. We'll stay with the sacrifices. They'll yield us much favor with the order.
Dagon. The chief's always up there napping. Why ain't he out here with us?
His time draws nigh. Martin can't rub his eyes properly no more. He'll take the water. Then it'll be me taking charge around here. And things will be done different. Now get inside and mind that you don't forget to bolt the door.
Don't move, outsider.
Seriously? I guess I'm running. I just grabbed something. I don't know what that was. They don't know where I am, right? But this is a weapon, so...
Shotgun, at last.
I don't know if you're meant to be seen there or if I just messed up. I don't know. I mean, what else can I do? Am I supposed to sneak behind them while they're having a conversation into the light? Where surely, realistically, you'd be seen behind them and then sneak around the corner? I don't even know. But anyway, I'm alive and I have a weapon, so everything should be fine. The aim button can be used with most weapons to aid accuracy. Aim for the legs to slow down an advancing enemy or hit the head for heavy damage. Avoid firing too quickly and don't forget to reload. Okay, if I remember right, the gunplay in this game is really good. And one of the coolest things about it is how hardcore it is. There is no crosshair. None. Sweet! Reenacting Half-Life.
Look everywhere.
Yep, no crosshair. I love it. I freaking love it. I love the fact that you have no crosshair. Okay.
A police whistle. Could prove useful.
How do I use it? Whoops.
Did you hear that?
It happened.
All right, well, they're coming to me. Oh, whoops. That was, wow, I'm doing, just kill me. Wow, I'm an idiot. Okay. Let's try this a third time. Oh my god. How do I use the police whistle, I say, as I whistle it right where I'm standing? At exactly the worst time possible.
What was that?
One more try. This time I'm going to...
Probably nothing.
I'm gonna sneak past them while they're talking. You can see what I mean about it seeming like they designed these scenes to play out like one way, basically. And if you do something wrong, like, you're supposed to know exactly what to do, it seems like, and if you do something wrong, you're just kind of screwed. Alright, let's see if this is what I'm supposed to do. Keep sneaking. I'm pretty sure the guy would see me. Yeah, look.
Did you hear that?
Did you hear that?
No, please. Okay, well. Not what I wanted to have happen. Alright, let's just kill him.
He's stolen a shotgun at last.
Reload. And heal. I'm near death.
There's nobody here.
Come on. You can do it, Jack Walters. You can do it. How do they not know I'm in here?
Widen the search. You'll not get there.
Okay. Yeah, I really love the fact that it does not give you a crosshair. And you don't even know how much ammo you have. Unless you actually check. How much do I have? I have 5 more shots of that, and 21 pistol. Okay. Weapon capacity 8 plus 1 chambered, okay. Alright, so what keys do I use to access this? 3 for this, 5 for the shotgun, gotcha. Okay, I think I'm good for now.
A police whistle. Could all the desk drawers are locked? Messing with the alarm would be too risky.
Agreed.
Look at me. You're safe.
And I'm losing my mind again.
I don't think I should use that right now.
Yeah, I do not have the combination.
What's happening?
It's locked.
What the hell am I doing here?
There's a journal in there.
Why don't you just go? You're gonna get us both in trouble.
Is that Brian Burnham?
I can hear them. Hear them in the walls. Rats.
Or is that Brian Burnham?
This is the rap sheet for Henry Garrison. No charge has been listed.
He's gone insane.
A rap sheet for Brian Burnham.
Quit bothering
me. No charge has been listed.
All right, so I need to break him out.
Are you Burnham?
Yes. What do you want?
The name's Jack Walters. I'm a private detective. Where do they keep the keys?
Why should I trust you?
What? In case you hadn't noticed, I thought. You're in a bit of a jam here.
It could be a trap.
Are you crazy?
Stop bothering me. They're gonna find you, Jack. And the order shows no mercy.
Are you serious? What, you don't want my help? Okay.
It's locked.
I guess I'll have to get him out against his will.
Inside me. It draws me to the dark ocean. I dream of Dagon. And of Hydra. I Cthulhu Mythos.
This doll. It must be Ramona's.
Oh, that's the father.
I remember Henry.
According to the sheet, Garrison has been holed up in the jail for nearly 6 months.
My real
6 months?
No, not him.
That's gotta be the father.
I had Dagon. Fatong.
There's no escape. I'll never make it out of here alive. Oh no, I can't think straight.
Oh god, this bathroom is disgusting.
The sink has been blocked up, leaving it full of scummy water.
Oh my god. Just like full of putrid water.
It won't open.
Alright, how much medical stuff do I have left? Pretty good, actually. Alright, there's a bunch out there. 1, 2. There's at least 2.
The fire is barely enough to keep out the freezing cold winds.
I love the way he delivers that line. Will he say it again?
The fire is dying down. There's nothing of use here.
Come on, say it again.
The fire is barely enough to keep out the freezing cold winds.
The delivery on that is perfect. The fire is barely enough to keep out the freezing cold winds.
The fire is dying down. There's nothing of use here. The fire is barely enough to
keep out the freezing cold winds. The fire is barely enough to keep out the freezing cold winds.
There's nothing of interest in the wardrobe.
That is really...
The keys to the cells. Now I can free Brian.
Yeah, whoever voice acts your character, Jack Walters, is mediocre. He can be good at times, but often his lines just sound really awkward, like this one.
The fire is dying down. There's nothing of use here.
Not that one. This one.
The fire is barely enough to keep out the freezing cold winds.
That sounds horrible. That is ridiculous. Alright, well, I mean, he wants me to go away, but surely he wants me to unlock him, right?
What is it you're really doing in Innsmouth, Jack? I'm not going anywhere till I know I can trust you.
Okay. How do I prove my loyalty?
Dagon.
Wait a minute.
Me, would you?
I just remembered this.
Ruth Billingham gave me this.
What? This is the photograph I gave her before. Oh, damn. I've been so foolish. I'm sorry. If Ruth trusts you, Jack, then so do I. Please, hurry and get this door open.
Good, you've come to your senses.
It's unlocked.
The garage on the main street holds an old automobile. It should be able to get us clear of town.
Should be able to?
If we can just make it through the patrols. Lead the way, Jack.
Scratching.
Wait, you're gonna follow me? I have to say that it's not going to go well. Can you stay here?
Quickly, we have to get away from the jail.
He's gonna ruin my cover if I try to sneak with him following me.
What are we still doing here?
Wait a minute, what about the safe?
Maybe later.
Okay.
The door's bolted shut.
We need to check the garage first.
All right, you got it. I don't know where the garage is, but...
This is it.
Oh, perfect.
Damn it! They're not normally locked. We'll have to find another way in. Where to now, Jack?
Maybe down this alleyway over here? Holy crap, weird FPS. Yep, look, my sensitivity is way too high until my FPS goes back up. And there we go. Now it's normal.
The doors are locked. You won't be able to get in that way. Come on, Jack. We need to get off the streets.
Be quiet or I'm gonna shoot you in the head. I'll do it. I will do it. Holy crap, the shadow of that moth looks like a bird. Alright, seriously, how do we get in?
The streets have no cover, Jack. We'll get caught.
Yes, thank you for pointing out the obvious. Alright. Here's what we're gonna do, okay? And go. Did they hear it? Yep, okay, let's go. What? Dude! You are fucking useless, dude. Really? Really?
Where is he?
No, stop. I won't take them back. I won't take the cursed.
What? Serpentine? Super Serpentine? Trying to make it hard to... He really doesn't want to get hit, does he? Oh my god, run in a circle, avoid the bullets!
Stop.
Okay, well, that did not go as planned, thanks to you. You piece of shit, where did you go, being useless? Where did you go? Come here.
Are you sure it's safe now?
Yes, I'm sure. Gunplay in this game is just so good.
What the hell was that? There's something down there.
Yes, there is something down there. I really don't want to go down there.
The streets have no cover, Jack. We'll get caught.
Alright, what's around the corner? Alright, no, we can't go that way. Alright, we need to enter there from the sewers, or, yeah, whatever this is. Gotta enter the garage from down below. Oh god, I do not want to go down here. What happened here?
From the mess, it looks like something, or someone, was killed here recently. The grate's too heavy to lift with my bare hands.
Ah, that's where this comes in handy.
Come on, Jack. We need to get off the streets.
Come on, you're the one that wanted to get off the streets. Come on down with me. Come on down! He's gonna regret wanting to get off the streets.
Something wrong down here. Something very wrong.
Yes.
This place has given me the creeps.
Yes, there is. Dead rats everywhere.
The rotting corpse of a rat. I suppose it might come in useful.
Wait, you can pick them up? What?
I think one dead rat is enough for anyone.
Why do I have a dead rat? A dead rat, not pleasant at all. No kidding. What do I do with it? I don't even remember.
What the hell was that noise? Oh, the stench here is sickening. It smacks of more than just sewage.
Bravo, Jack. Congratulations on your new promotion to Innsmouth's enemy number one.
Shut your trap, Maggie. You're not a factory inspector. Who do you work for?
Okay, detective. I'll come clean. I'm an undercover agent for the United States Treasury Department. We've been working closely with the FBI on a secret investigation of Innsmouth. I'm the inside man.
Really? What have you been able to find out?
The Innsmouth look, Jack. It's at the heart of the problems in this town. More than half the population must be infected by now. The spreading of that contagion, or whatever the hell you want to call it, is the key. I just know it.
This is all very interesting, fellas, but we gotta get out of Innsmouth with Ruth.
She's waiting for us at some old fishing cannery, just past the station to Rowley.
Listen, Jack. There are some agents watching the road not far past that spot. If you can make it there, you'll be safely picked up.
I need you to do something for me. You can do it while I get this thing started. When they arrested me, they took a brooch I was carrying. It belonged to Ruth. It carries her picture inside. I won't leave it behind.
Seriously?
Are you crazy? We don't have time for this.
They'll be holding it in the jail office safe.
I don't know the combination.
I overheard Ropes talking to one of the other guards. He said something about an important date. And someone called Captain Obed Marsh. If you have a dig around the jailhouse, I'm sure you'll find something.
If you want to get in through the back door, just knock, and I'll open it for you.
Really, do you really think finding your brooch, or brooch, whatever the hell it was, is important right now, really? Fine? Jesus Christ, dude. I hate you. First you were a whiny piece of shit when I was trying to break you out of jail, and now you want me to go risk my life for a little tiny trinket. I get that it has sentimental value, but I value my life more than the sentimentality. And now I hate you even more because I mistalked while talking about your stupidity. Fuck you.
The door's bolted shut.
All right, let's do this. Oh yeah, the date. Obed Marsh. Or is it 46? Mm-hmm. So that'd be this date, right? 19th of June. 1846. Oh god, is this gonna be another one where I go to enter the date password and for some reason it doesn't work? That would be annoying. Wait, so... Alright. 1846. Alright, before I continue, I will be right back. Okay, let's see if there's any more patrols. Of course, there's more patrols.
Come here.
You come here. 'Cause I'm a good shot, asshole. Can I pick up their weapon? No, they disappear, okay. Hold on, I want to use up my shotgun ammo, actually. There we go. Anyone else want to try me? Okay. Some more out front. One, two. Oh, someone's running. I see three. One person running. Alright.
It's no use. I don't know the combination.
Maybe he's got away.
Wait, I don't... What? I don't know the combi... Are you kidding me? Yes, I do. I do know the combination.
It's no use. I don't know the combination.
It's given right here. The date that Obed Marsh was arrested, right? Took control. Right?
It's no use. I don't know the combination.
I don't understand. Is there something else I have that relates to Obed Marsh? Wait, Book of Dagon. When the hell did I get this? This book is handwritten and heavily bound. Its cover is embossed with the title, The Book of Dagon. It seems to be a religious work, translated from a series of ancient tablets. It tells of an entity called Dagon, apparently some kind of sea god, and his consort, Hydra. They are the greatest of an underwater race called the Deep Ones, who worship them with sacrifices and other rites. The descriptions of the sacrifices are particularly shocking, and there are details of magical spells and other strange rituals. If this incredible manuscript is to be believed, their history stretches back beyond the remotest human origins into unthinkably remote antiquity. Wait, have I read this? I've either read this or I've had this read to me. A few individuals are so incredibly old that they have seen continents rise and fall, for they do not die of old age as humans do. Father Dagon and Mother Hydra are such individuals and are greatly revered for their age and size. Their greatest awe, however, is reserved for a dark god named Great Cthulhu, who is said to sleep and dream in the underwater city of... I don't know how to pronounce that. I don't know. The book seems incomplete. The last chapters tail off, as though the translation has not been finished. anything here about Obid Marsh? Why does it think I don't know the combination? I don't get it.
It's no use. I don't know the combination.
Okay, let's go out and shoot everyone. Let's do that. See if there's something to discover over here. Let's just do this. Come on. Come for me. I'm waiting. Seriously, they're not coming?
Don't move, outsider.
Yeah, so far the combat's really easy. Did I just kill everyone? Not quite. Come on.
Stop! Die, outsider! Die!
You people are not very smart. Oh god. They might be coming unlimitedly. I have a lot of shotgun left though. Come on.
Without him, die.
Yeah, okay, they're gonna keep coming. This is a bad idea.
A wanted poster for Brian Burnham.
Alright, so where do I go to get this date? Fuck off, please.
Come here.
What are you doing?
Shooter!
Okay, this is a really bad scene. This doesn't make any sense. They're literally just spawning unlimited enemies. I mean, I might have even broken the game. Because I should know the date. I do know the date. But for some reason it won't let me enter it, which makes me think I broke it. I don't know. Alright. Oh, my leg's broken. That does not sound good. You might want to be faster there, Jack. Yeah, this is a really poorly done scene. I mean, I can't enter the date even though I know it. My reason for being here at all is because of the stupid thing that I need to get for the idiot. And the enemies are coming unlimitedly, which is really dumb. Knock, knock.
Brian, it's me. Open up.
I'm still not done with the car yet, Jack.
I know, trust me, I know. I just think I might have broken the game.
The government must have known about Innsmouth for a long time. Why the sudden interest?
A few years back, some new hotshot was made head of the FBI. His name's Hoover. He's on a personal mission to wipe crime from this country. He's a good agent. Just don't tell him any jokes.
Well, I think I'm gonna die here, so that won't be any problem.
Won't open.
I mean, it's saying I don't know the combination, so what do I need to do to get it? Obviously, it's not something I need to figure out, because it doesn't matter what I figure out. My character needs to know something. Like, I mean, what do I need to do? What can I do that would make my character understand something? Alright, well, I've already wasted, like, all of my ammo. So, let's load this.
These trash cans are empty. These posters are everywhere.
Alright, let's be stealthy this time. Right or not. Hopefully that'll get their attention over there. Alright, I think I'm good here. Yep, I'm good here. Let me just lock this. Boom!
Show yourself, outsider.
All the desk drawers are locked. I should leave the alarm alone. All kinds of miscellaneous notes. All the desk drawers are locked. It's no use. I don't know the combination.
I don't know the combination.
I already cleaned out the gun cabinet.
Wait, you can keep reloading your weapon? Wait, does that waste ammo or what? 16. No, it doesn't. Okay.
It's no use. I don't know the combination. It's unlocked.
Oh. I need to access the other jail cells and get the... Okay, got it. Got it, got it, got it. Yep, ship logs of Captain Obed Marsh. March 6th, 1823. Still en route to China, eastward from whatever that is, or Tahiti, as it is also called. We have encountered an island that does not appear on our charts. I ordered the anchor dropped close inshore, and we sent the longboat for fresh water and supplies. The islanders are not interested in trading for gold, of which they have apparently a great quantity. I asked after its source, in the hope of setting up a mining and milling operation on shore. In response to my questioning, I was taken to a smaller island nearby and shown some stone ruins, apparently of great antiquity. The designs carved upon them are like nothing I have ever seen in all my travels. This, they say, is the city of the sea gods, who can be prevailed upon to give them gold for the asking. I suspect is a remnant of a higher civilization, now lost. The natives evidently find gold among the ruins. I questioned the island's chief, Elder, at length about the ruins, and was answered with the retelling of legends so savage and fantastic that I wonder at them. Perhaps, when the gold is secured and with it my own fortune, I shall reveal the island's location and open it to scholarship. Having traded for a large quantity of gold in addition to the needed water and fresh food, we resumed our voyage. I impressed upon the crew the need for absolute silence about this island, for if word were to get out, others would be sure to go there. Shortly before our departure, Chief Wallakia made me a gift of several small metal discs, evidently of the same workmanship as the ruins. By means of these and certain chants, he said, the sea gods could be summoned and induced to bring their gifts. June 4th, 1838. Revisiting the mysterious island, we could find no trace of the people with whom we have traded for so many years. Their villages are razed to the ground, and no trace can be found of them. It appears that some other tribe has attacked and destroyed them. The men are much dismayed that we shall no longer be able to obtain gold here unless we discover its source for ourselves. A day's searching among the ruins availed us nothing, although certain of the crew were troubled by nightmares subsequently. It appears that this voyage is destined to be without profit, and we must return to Innsmouth with both hands and pockets empty. A most troubling turn of events. The town has come to rely upon us, and the gold that we bring back, to make up for the trade that was lost when the War of 1812 ended. What shall become of our home port now, and us along with it? August 18th, 1838. While looking over these souvenirs and curiosities I collected on my Pacific voyages, seeking some comfort and happier memories, I happened upon the strange metal discs given to me by old Wallachia and his people. I had quite forgotten them, and the stories he told about the gold-bearing gods from the sea, but now, an idea is stirring within me. I do not know whether to embrace it, as Innsmouth's last hope, or to concede that desperation has driven me insane. Am I mad? The gold we brought from the island was real enough. Perhaps the sea gods are real also. A sailor to far ports sees many strange things and learns to keep an open mind. After much effort in recollection, I've remembered the chants Wallachia taught me. Tonight, I shall row out to Devil's Reef and try them, along with the discs. Perhaps the sea gods will save us, or if not, I shall acknowledge my folly and retire to the asylum. Later that night, the sea gods are real. I've seen them, and spoken with them. I carry some of their gold. A token of more to come, I am assured. But the price... Yet can any price be too high when one's own home is at stake? Innsmouth shall rise again. July 23rd, 1846. This is a day of crisis. For Innsmouth, I and those loyal to me have been seized and thrown in jail by our pious neighbors. Ready enough to enjoy the prosperity I have returned to the town, they scruple at the means I use and the powers I wield. They must be taught a lesson. They have no idea of the powers they seek to defy. The terrible bargain I made was irrevocable, and by locking me up they bring great peril to the town, the very town that they would save from my influence. But it is too late for salvation. As surely as I know the morning tide will rise, I know that those from the reef will come to Innsmouth. They will come in search of those things I have been prevented from giving them, and they will come to punish those who have prevented me. Little do the righteous dream of the horror they will visit, that will visit Innsmouth this night. There will be great destruction. 1846 will be recorded in the town's annals as a year of unparalleled calamity. I shall make certain that 1846 also marks the beginning of a new age. An age in which no threat to our pact is tolerated. From this year on, I shall play the tyrant, and my descendants shall do so after me. But we do so to avert a greater evil.
An old ship's log, marked with the name Obed Marsh.
Okay, yes, game, I get it. You mentioned the date many, many times. I get that that is the password, okay? It's like the game is smacking me across the head with the fact that that's the password. No kidding. I get it.
Henry, they called me. My father called me Henry.
He's crazy.
My real
father. I don't think it would be the sharpest plan to let him out.
Not him. No. I, Dagon.
It's unlocked. Taking the doll would be just too weird.
I agree.
It's Thomas Waits. Ramona's death must have driven him to cutting his own throat.
Okay, now I get... Like, I'm glad that I read that note about Obed Marsh, about his journeys, because it was interesting to read. But why did I have to read that to be able to unlock this? That doesn't make any sense. I already knew the date. 1846. I didn't need that note.
I must have got something wrong.
I didn't need that note to get the password, so why did it require me to read it? I don't know, but you know what I'm thinking? I think I need to put this guy out of his misery. I mean, just look at him. Look at him.
I can hear them. Hear them in the walls. Rats. Rats in the walls. I hear them. So very tasty.
I think I need to put him out of his misery. He's been here for what, 6 months?
This is the rap sheet for Henry Garrison. No charge has been listed. According to this sheet, Garrison has been holed up in the jail for nearly 6 months.
Out. Out. Deep in the abyss.
Should I kill him?
On the wreath of Satan at last.
Why on earth? I mean, I was insane too, basically. But I... now I'm here. I've gotten better. Kind of. Okay, I'm not gonna kill him. Alright. 1846. Do 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 do. 1 8 4 6. Wow, it was put there by one of the deep ones.
This must be Ruth's brooch.
Don't move, Sasha.
Damn, if you don't hit him in the head, they take a lot of shots. Okay, let's run for it. I'm legging it. Alright, I think I took a shot there. Let me heal up.